No.
Yes? Just a minute, please. Yes? Oh, Dr. Martin.
How is he? Well, the slender thread is holding. Dr. Jordan, you've been absolutely selfless, but you cannot go without sleep 24 hours a day. I brought my nurse.
I don't need any ancient crone hovering over me.
My regular nurse, Miss Prendergast, is visiting her family, but Ellen has been very helpful on several cases. Ben, you remember Ellen? Lucy Clark's granddaughter.
Little Ellen. Come over here, my dear. You've matured beautifully, Ellen.
Why, Mr. Cartwright, you saw me only last week.
This illness, just my head.
Oh, poor dear Mr. Cartwright.
Lovely, lovely, cool fingers, my dear.
Ben, I'm glad you decided to listen to reason.
I was sure he would. Dr. Martin.
I think he's a little better today. I'll keep you informed if he takes any turn for the worse. Why, I'll
do that, Doctor.
I'll let you know, all right?
Yeah.
My dear, I feel my strength waning. Perhaps an alcohol rub.
Oh, I'm very good at that.
Oh. Mrs. Cartwright, I'm afraid we'll have to postpone the alcohol rub. There are businessmen waiting downstairs to see you.
Yes, of course.
Come on. Quietly.
Is something wrong, Doctor?
No. I'm just going into town for some additional medication.
Oh, Mr. Cartwright hasn't had a relapse.
Oh, no. I'm happy to report that he's having his first comfortable night. But he must not be disturbed.
Oh.
Rest is the absolute key.
I will make a sound.
I knew I could count on you.
Doctor, can I tell you something? I wasn't sure I wanted to become a nurse, but working with you, I realize what a noble profession it is. I'm going to make it my life's work.
Ellen, you're much too pretty to waste your life in a drab uniform.
Ellen?
Oh, how could you dare come here after what you've done?
Ellen, I had to say goodbye before I give myself up.
Well, you might have saved yourself the trouble.
Ellen, you don't understand. I'm innocent. I was fooled by Meredith like everyone else. He's clever.
And what about all that money you took?
Ellen, I don't know anything about the money. When Mr. Cartwright arrived, I just panicked and ran. I saw my whole medical career finished. Ellen, it doesn't matter what happens to me, but I could have done so much to ease the suffering of other people.
Well, you can explain all this to the sheriff and Mr. Cartwright.
No. It's too late. I'll be tarred by the same brush as Meredith. If I had lost my head, I would have been on my way to California. A few months of research, and I would have found what I have been searching for years.
What?
The cure for yellow fever.
Well, the world mustn't suffer for this one mistake. You're making a terrible mistake. He's a fine man.
He's a fine man, all right. He's wanted in 6 states. I gotta hand it to you, Meredith. Where'd he go? No. Who let him get away?
He'll be back someday. I'm afraid.